two days I often think about. I call them the Alsatian Day and the Doberman Day. On the Alsatian Day, I met her in the underground and we fell in love. And on the Doberman Day, I knew I hated her. I saw a lot of girls on the underground that day. I even remember one. She passed me in a tunnel like a strange dark bird displaying her shiny feathers. But she wasn't Helen. Maybe if the little black bird in the tunnel had smiled at me, she would have been the next. But it was Helen who smiled.
Hello.
You're looking very guilty about something. What have you been up to? You can tell me.
Nothing, I've just been sitting here.
Well, nothing, nothing at all.
Well, no, not nothing. I've been working. A woman brought a guard dog in.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, it's a Doberman. I'm going to do it snarling to frighten burglars. And I think she wants to rig it up so that a burglar could trigger off barking sounds. And then maybe the dog could be on rail tracks or something.
Wouldn't it be easier to buy a live Doberman?
Well, no, no, she's allergic to dogs. Yeah, she gets sick, she gets a rash.
I see. So, where did she get this dog?
She bought it.
What, and then killed it?
No, it was dead when she bought it.
I see. So, where does she live?
Where does she live? Helen, your hair looks very nice. I don't know where she lives. Why do you ask?
Well, I was just wondering where the hell she managed to buy a dead Doberman. So how did it die?
Well, I think it broke its neck. I was just examining it. Oh,
I must tell you, my sister's got a new man.
Angelica?
No, Rachel. Oh God, there's a dead mouse in here. That must have been thirsty. Must have crawled around the edge, tried to take a sip of water and fell in. Poor thing. Imagine it swimming around, trying to get a grip on the edge.
Oh, that's perfect.
What do you mean?
Well, it's just that it's an undamaged mouse.
Oh, God, you're not going to stuff it, are you?
Of course I am. Not often you get a wild animal that's undamaged, freshly dead. I'd be stupid to throw it away.
Poor thing.
Why poor thing?
No, just forget it.
Well, we can have this argument if you want. I'm not doing anything.
Just forget it.
Seriously?
Oh, forget it, Anthony. Anyway, I want to tell you about this woman at the office. You wouldn't believe it. She's very normal looking. In her 40s. Fat. You know, those sort of rose-tinted glasses. Well, the boss said that she'd been in the papers, so I decided to find out for myself. I saw her going into this cafe. I went in, and suddenly she started telling me that she's married to this man who's a convicted murderer and a life sentence. And she met him. And she met him while he was in prison, so they never made love. And they've only kissed once. Oh, and she said he murdered his first wife. So weird.
Yeah. Look, Helen, I've got to go over and have lunch with my parents tomorrow. Now, I'd like you to come, of course, but you can't.
Island. I've got to go over and see my parents for lunch. I tried to tell you last night, but, you fell asleep.
Ha, that's a joke.
Anyway, it's just lunch. I won't be long.
So is it me you're ashamed of, or your parents?
I'm not ashamed of anybody. It's just that my father's a very difficult man.
I'd like to meet him. I'm sure he's not that bad.
Helen, he's quite mad. I'm talking about a man who spent his whole life stuffing animals for no reason. He's never sold one. He's never even tried to sell one. I told you before, he's never even shown them to anybody.
I don't see there's much difference between you and him. I mean, you spend your whole time stuffing animals as well.
It's what I do for a living, darling. I practically grew up in my father's workshop. I've had the best training in taxidermy you could possibly imagine. I'm hardly going to just throw it away. It's in my blood. I might as well use it. £400 I got for that Alsatian.
But I'm not talking about the pets so much as the other animals. I mean, what was all that business with the mouse? You can't have had more than 2 hours sleep.
I don't need much sleep. I just did the mouse because once in a while I like to do something that's a bit wild. Something you can't appreciate when it's alive because you can't get near to it. You try and look at a wild animal and it runs away from you. You try and stroke one, it'll bite you. I just get sick of doing pets.
That Alsatian could have given you a good nip.
Yeah, if you got on the wrong side of his owner.
But the real beauty of taxidermy is that you can have something like a fox in your living room. A fox wouldn't come within 1,000 yards of you when it's alive. You know, the day we met, I was on my way to see the man who owns that dog.
Really?
I'll never forget that day.
When I saw you on the underground, I couldn't stop staring at you. And when we got off at the same station and I lost you in the crowd, I felt really depressed. I'd been lonely for a long time before that day. But for me, the loneliness ended the moment I saw you getting into your seat opposite me on that train. Because I was so attracted to you. I knew I wasn't going to let you get away from me twice. And it was too beautiful a coincidence to just let it pass. And most of all, I knew we were going to be able to start a conversation. Because in those situations, that's half the battle.
Some of that home cooking.
Oh, Aunt, couldn't I come? I know your father's eccentric, but I don't mind, really, I don't.
Helen, it's not that I don't want you to see my parents. It's just I don't want you to see the effect they have on me. Why don't you go and see your sister?
Yeah, I think I will. I'll go and see Rachel.
Bye, darling.
Bye.
Helen, what the hell are you doing here?
Oh my God! You stabbed her!
Helen!
See, you've met the girls. Though, I don't remember inviting you here. Still, seeing as you're here, I suppose it'd be rude of me not to introduce you. Helen, this is Harriet and Ellie, and this is Sophie. This is Sam, and this, well, it was a little ambitious of me at the time. But I think you'll agree, the rest aren't looking too bad. You seem very quiet.
Anthony, you are going to let me go?
Well, now I'd like to. I wasn't ready for this. But it's no good, Helen! You're just like the rest, always meddling and snooping. Always charging around and rabbiting on. I can't understand why you people can't just stay still. Now calm down, darling. It's not so bad. You're going to be beautiful forever. Wouldn't you like that?